Hey, what's good YouTube? This is Brandon. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to do a whole beef tenderloin. We're going to clean it up, cook it up, and slice it up. Stay tuned. All right, y'all. Here's the tenderloin. This is a almost 4 pound tenderloin. Not quite. And this one already has some trimming done. If you get a PISMO, which stands for peeled side muscle on, it will have a nice piece of muscle on this side, like a skirt almost, another piece on this side, and a lot more fat on the bottom. But this one has been peeled pretty well, so we're not going to worry about it. Some of this fat you can even get off with your fingers. A lot of this trimming can be done by hand without even a knife. That's what makes it so easy, a tenderloin trimming so easy, that you can just use your hand to get a lot of it off. Just like that. So you want to get a lot of this fat off of there and just peel it off, even that little membrane, so you can see how much cleaner it is already. Now the one thing we will have to use our knife for is the silver skin. So the easiest way to do that, make sure you have a nice sharp knife, turn it to where it's easy for you. And you just want to go underneath that, lift it, and just follow it toward the head of the tenderloin at an angle. Trim it on off. Very little meat comes with it. And now you have that silver skin off. So we're just going to finish cleaning that up. Like I said, just get underneath it with a sharp knife. Take it toward the back. Lift. Now, clean it on up. Now, if I have one bit of advice for folks, man, I would encourage you to start trying to buy, you know, the whole roast, or whether it be a pork loin or a beef tenderloin. If you can afford it and you have the real estate in your refrigerator or your freezer, because you're going to save so much more money buying this stuff whole and just breaking it down yourself. So a beef tenderloin, you can get, it might be $10.99 a pound. Once you allow that butcher to break it down and peel it, that price might go up to $14 or $15.99 a pound. Once that butcher peels it and then cuts it into steaks, now you're paying $23.99 for filet mignon. And that's all that this is. This is filet mignon. It's your beef tenderloin. Once it's cut into steaks, filet mignon. So, you know, start buying your meat whole. I just bought a whole pork loin the other day from Sam's Club. It was on sale for $1.18 a pound. And it's about a six pound loin. But I looked at the price of the boneless chops. The boneless chops were $4.49 a pound. So you're gonna be saving over $3 a pound if you just take it and break it down yourself. So guys, I encourage you to do that stuff yourself. I'm gonna just trim the tail off and then save this. This will make some good steak and eggs for breakfast tomorrow. So that's what I'm gonna do here. Take a little bit more of the fat out of here. And that's it. Now, I got a little more silver skin. Let me grab that out of there real quick. Chew on that. So there, now it's all cleaned up, trimmed. Now we just got to season it. What I'm going to use to season it, that Kinder's The Blend salt, pepper, garlic. Super basic on this thing. You don't want to overpower with all types of different seasonings, so we are going to season it pretty heavy. Here. now. I'm just gonna let it rest in my refrigerator for a little while and get my pit set up. When we go out there to the pit, I'll go ahead and let you guys see you in a minute. All right, guys, I decided to bring you in and see the little side dish I'm gonna make with this tenderloin. What we have is about a pound of those little petite potatoes, and then almost a full bag of mini sweet peppers. We're just gonna roast those off in the oven, but first we're gonna doctor them up a little bit, and that's gonna make for an awesome side dish to go with our tenderloin. First things first, we're gonna add a heap of garlic. We're looking at about a teaspoon to a teaspoon and a half of garlic. Now you can season this to taste, so if you're a huge garlic fan, go heavier with the garlic. If you're not a big garlic fan, then you know, hold up a little bit. We're gonna go with black pepper. This complete seasoning by Badia, one of my favorites, so you're gonna go heavy with that. Like I said, it's almost impossible to over salt your food with this body. It's almost always just right. All right, let me grab my olive oil. Hit it with a couple tablespoons of olive oil. Then we've got some fresh parsley. I'm gonna add that in there for a color. Let's mix it up. Then we're just gonna add it to a baking dish. And that's gonna go in a 375 degree oven. Put the tenderloin on. We're using our Jumbo Joe today. We've got a little basket full of charcoal, and I've got one little hickory chunk on there. I don't want to over smoke this tenderloin, but I do want a little bit of a smoke flavor on it, so that's why we got that little hunk of hickory on there. We're just gonna put it on the Jumbo Joe and let it ride. I'm going to put a temperature probe in it because I want to take it to about 125 degrees. Then we're going to put a little bit of a sear on it. And that's going to be it, y'all. So, got my little Maverick thermometer. Just want to put it into the thick part. And I'm going to go through the head into the middle there. Like I said, we're just going to try to take it to 125 degrees. And once it reaches 125, we'll go ahead and put a little sear on it and take it to 140, and we'll be able to let it rest and eat. Close it up. All right, y'all. See you in a little bit. All right, y'all. We've reached 125 degrees. See how it's looking? Now we're just going to roll it and let it get a little sear over this charcoal as best we can. So just want to take it now. Just move it over that charcoal and let it do its thing for a little bit. Like I say, we're just going to take it to 140 degrees, then we're going to take it in the house and let it rest. No basting or nothing done to this tenderloin. It only took about really 45 minutes to take it to 125, so it doesn't take very long with these tenderloins. We're just gonna keep on letting it cook, and I'll catch you guys here in a minute. All right, we went on and flipped it over, guys. Just looking to get a little bit of a char on it, like you can see right there. So, thing smells fantastic.
Say, all we're doing is taking it to 140 degrees just so we can get a good medium to medium rare on it. That's what we like in our house, so nice little warm pink on the inside. It's up to 135 right now, so it shouldn't be too much longer. Then we'll take it on in the house and let it rest up a bit. See you guys in a minute. That's the finished product. 140 degrees. You guys take a good look at it. Beautiful. Now all we got left to do is put on the cutting board, let it rest up a little while, and I'll see you when I get the slices.
Family, welcome. Here are those potatoes and peppers that we made earlier as a side. Looking delicious. Roasted, soft, and I love these potatoes because they have like a little bit of a pop when you bite into them. Like a little bit of a snap. I just love them so much. They're delicious. Then I went on and roasted up some Brussels sprouts, a little garlic, a little bacon, and some good seasoning too. So that's what we're going to have to go with our steak. But now the piece de resistance.
All right, y'all.
The time we've been waiting for. It's time to slice this bad boy up. I like to slice them thin, feed my family with them, so we're not, if you, you know, normally order filet mignon, no, most of the time, it's quite naturally, it's cut, then cooked as a steak, that's filet mignon. This is this roasted or smoked pork, beef tenderloin, and I'm just going to go with fairly thin slices, that way we can stretch it a little bit, but, and you can see, perfectly cooked, exactly what we want. That medium, the medium rare, perfect. Just gonna cut some about half inch medallions. That's what we're looking for. Now, if you don't like your meat quite as rare or whatever, just go ahead and cook it a little longer. Or you can cook it this way and then slice it and then put it back on the grill and sear it at steaks and take it to wherever you want to. But to me, when you're eating tenderloin or filet mignon, it'd be a shame to cook it to well done. There's no point in that to me. So let's go ahead and get a taste. Oh yeah. That Kinder seasoning, you can taste that garlic, that salt, that pepper. I'm telling y'all, that is an amazing seasoning. It doesn't cost an arm and a leg. And you can pick it up at Sam's Club. It's really good. But that's it, guys. We're going to get these plates plated up. And I'll see you guys at a different time. If you guys like this video, please make sure you like, comment, subscribe. I appreciate you guys following me. God bless y'all. And good night.